Well, hello everybody. Welcome back to another wonderful day of Sharlenwar's adventure in 7 days to die. Hello, and if you notice, you'll see it's Alpha 15, build 83. So we're on the experimental build, and I'm gonna kind of you go through a few things and then we'll go from there. So if we look in our options under player profiles, you'll notice there's a whole bunch of new profiles. I think these were in here before, but anyways, you have access to these, and then you can actually go into here and you can actually edit your character. You can, there's these sliders that you can manipulate to kind of change the look of your character, body, blah blah blah, all that fun stuff, right? So we have all that in the game, which is pretty cool, pretty cool. So if I go okay, I think we can do that. Sharlenwar, okay. Yeah, and now if we go under editing tools, this is a really cool feature. So basically you can type in the seed of your world. So if we were gonna start a single player campaign, I would go experiment, so I would probably call it Alpha 15 Experi. And the size just generates the size of the map. And so basically what you do is you just click this button and it gets generated. Okay, so as you can see, here we have our map that is generated with this seed, which is pretty cool. And as you can see, we can zoom in on it. We can even move it around as such. And so basically what would happen is we would spawn inside this world and then we would decide where to go. So it looks like there's like 1, 2, 3 normal villages, I think. And then we have a hub city. Looks like there's a couple hub cities. I would consider these structures as hub cities, right? Because there's nothing in these squares, as you can tell. So we can zoom down here. Ah, oh, there's stuff in here now. So this kind of tells you what the structures are, but it all kind of goes over each other. So for example, there's army barracks at this road here. There's this town here. So if anything, this would be the best place, kind of create a base, maybe like in one of these places, the camp tower or the like anywhere in here. So looks like we're gonna get some cool generation. Or we can even build a base right in this place here. And then even that would be okay. I think these are the biomes as well. So the blue stuff, I'm thinking maybe is water, but it doesn't make sense because if you look, why would the city generate into the water, right? So not sure how well this operates, right? How it functions. Maybe the road would be through the water and this would be flattened area in the city, but yeah. But let's do a larger size just to see what it does. Okay, so here we are. So it's a much larger world, and so if we zoom out, we can kind of then see the pattern that gets generated. So it looks like they've changed the density of the cities, because I don't remember there being this many in such a small area. Unless this is a really large map, then I guess that's different. But yeah, so not sure how you can use this to cheat, but you can kind of you preview the world and decide if you want to choose it or not. So we're going to pick it anyways. So we just exit out of this and let's go new game. So I was doing a single player game just to kind of test it out. So we're going to do single player, we're going to do random gen. Because random gen has all the point of interest in it. It has the traders and all that fun stuff. And so yeah, so we're going to call it Alpha 15 Experi, because I think that's all we can type in before. And let's actually go experimental. Okay, so let's check out the options. So we're gonna pick, I believe, the typical difficulty, nomad. All this stuff is, let's see here, I think all the difficulty does is it just makes them more of a bullet sponge. So there's no real point in changing this. Here we go, see, kind of tells you on the right hand side there. Daylight length, I always change this to 18 because I like more sun than night. The night is kind of irritating, but hey, it's always cool. Here we have default, which means they run at night, and during the day they are normal. Normal aggression. Feral is really challenging. Persistent profiles, that's obviously so that way if you have a profile, it keeps your stuff. And then modded, I usually have a 60-minute day cycle. What else can we look in here? Is block durability, so normal, loot abundance, I always keep it 100, it seems to be just fine. Loot respawn time, we've never really actually messed with this, but by default it's set to 30 days. drop on death, we're gonna actually pick everything this time. So if we die, we're gonna lose our whole bag. So we're gonna try not to die. That's kind of the point of this kind of Alpha 15 experimental branch or whatever you want to call it. All right, and so enemy spawning, I was playing on very high. I'm not sure if I'll go on that. I think medium is the default. I wish this was more percentage instead of kind of like, I guess it tells you on the right hand side, but it just might be better to have percentage in here versus just low, medium, high. It's kind of redundant. Airdrops by default is every 3 days, so we might as well keep that. Cheat mode off. Mark airdrops. This one I like to turn on because it's kind of dumb. It's kind of dumb not to mark them. I guess you don't need it, but I played on some modded servers that kind of tell you the coordinates, and I don't know if that's the right way to do or to do it. So yeah. So anyways, let's just jump right in. You grab your drink and your tasty treats, and yeah, let's get started. Okay, excellent. So here we are in our world. This tells you the quest, blah, blah, blah. Yada, yada, yada. Okay, so first things first, what you're going to do in the world is you're going to collect stone. So these things you pick up is only one stone. It should be two, but for some reason, the one you're going to want to collect plant fibers. And basically, if you stay in your immediate area where you spawn in, then you should have a relatively safe time. So we need to, of course, start exploring. We need to start. So we got a tree here. So maybe we'll hit that tree. So everything we have is here nearby. So basically just start collecting resources. There's a bird's nest here, which we'll need. I'm going to pick up some more stones. We got this cool rock here. We got even, we even have clay here. Snowberries. Oh, man, look at this stuff. Just got a lot of different stuff here. We got some more stone. Also, what's cool with Alpha 15 is just this. You can look all around, right? So maybe we can spot some civilization. We can spot like a road down there, kind of, sort of. So that's pretty cool. Now I'm hoping down the road they're going to make it where you can see trees all the way in the distance, kind of like a consistent kind of landmass and whatnot. So I'm just kind of picking this stuff up. You can probably hit this stuff to pick it up too. That would work as well. So this will give you athletics, I think. So we definitely want to do this. Here's a rock up here which we can kind of hit. So I'm just going to collect a bunch. Okay, and so let's do this stone axe. I just always type it in, so it's always faster. And it looks like we have the wood. We're going to craft this. We're going to need to hit this for some stone. Oh, look at this stuff. Look at this. That's interesting. Huh. Some interesting features here. There's looks like some Arctic zone down there. Some more pathways over there. Oh man, I know. So maybe I know where we are. I might know where we are, which would be kind of good. Let's see here. So we have the stone axe. We need plant fiber, which we have. Let's create this stuff. So we're going to need one of each, of course. A hood, pants, shirt, shoes, and gloves. I think I did. Okay. We're going to throw this stuff into our inventory here. The bandage always carry on me. Stone axe down here. We can shift click these back and forth. That's another thing you can do. Let's... Oh yeah, so I'm not going to quite wear these yet because you know what that means. You know that there's going to be quests where it's going to ask you to put the stuff on. Oh, I also should make a shovel. We should make a stone shovel for the clay since we're here at the clay. So we're going to do this. We could technically hang out here because there is a lot of rocks that we can harvest. There's some chrysanthemum here, which we definitely want. Because this stuff, you can farm everything now. And our first order of business will be to try and find your leather, right? Because we need to make the forge. And then from the forge, then we can make the workbench and so forth and so on. There's also a bunch of skills and stuff in the game. They've changed the skills. They've revamped them a bit. So that's kind of cool. But again, this is experimental. And there have been a lot of changes already considerably. From the build that Madball was doing on his playthrough to here, right? So now we're on build 83 in the top right hand corner. Look at that, there's a stag already. Oh man, we should make a wooden club. So it's directing us to do that. So we go wooden club. I want to chop this tree down because we get a seed for it, so that's definitely important. As you can tell, the skill of a level 1, or skill, the durability of a level 1 axe is terrible. And I do need, do I have feathers? No, I don't have feathers, so we have not spotted any bird's nests here at the moment. So let me chop this tree down, and then we'll try and find some bird's nests around here. Man, this is so cool. Okay, come on, come on. Bang. Okay, do we get a seed for that? Oh, snap. Did you see that? It hit me. It didn't kill us, but it hit me. Let's do wooden bow. Let's craft one of these ones, since we need that. We need more plant fiber. What we have is definitely not enough. Snowberry. There should be a bird's nest around here somewhere. So, oh, look at, there's even aloe vera there, looks like. We do want that. We can plant seeds for that. Some stone. Is that stone right here? I thought that was. Okay. Come on, come on. Okay, so we're in kind of like a more dry area. There's the yucca fruit. Or yucca fruit. These yucca plants give off fruit, which then you can eat, and you can even turn into yucca juice. Come on, where's the bird's nest? There's a rock right here. Bird's nest right over here, I think. No. Garbage can. Oh, good, we got a jar, which is excellent. That will last us longer. Also, what's good for plant fibers are these cacti. They will... oh, here we go. Here's a bird's nest. They change the texture of those. There we go. We got some feathers. Let's craft some arrows. Arrows will use stone. And yeah, so we're going to need to pound on some stone here. So let's go back over into this biome. Oh, yeah, that's fine. We'll let him run. We don't need the food right away, so we're going to go back to this biome here. There's a bunch of rocks. Okay. And then right here, we want to make a stone shovel. That's another thing I need to make, because that's important. Okay, so let us pound on this rock for some. So we're going to get stone, and we're going to get kind of raw iron. That raw iron we can then put into a forge. And of course, you know what happens with that, right? I just had a mishap with my drink. I'm going to have a sip here. Okay, do we have a bunch of rocks? We do. We're going to make some arrows. Just going to make them all from the feathers here. So we're going to make all 15. Might as well. Going to continue pounding on this a bit. We're going to use up this stone axe here. So we're carrying on with the quest, which is pretty awesome. So now it's a base thing, right? So that we will do at some point here. So, but right now we're going to worry about this. We're going to scrap this, and we're going to make another stone axe. We can actually favorite these things as well. We can do this, so that way they show up in this favorite list here. At least, I want to think it does. Ah, oh, come on. So brutal. It's supposed to be favorited, but I noticed that there's just bugs with certain stuff, right? So, if we then type... is it stone axe? There we go. Let's make another one. Let's have two axes on the go. I'm gonna collect some more rocks here. This might not be the best for rocks, and you might want to use something else, but for our purpose, it should be okay. Dang it, I almost want to hit this tree. So where are we? Let's kind of put a marker here. I'm going to put spawn point. Just so that way we have a point of reference so we can find our way back maybe. Maybe kind of harvest the rocks here. I do have that stone shovel. We do have the bow on hand. We do need to reload so that way you have your bow knocked or whatever it's called. Or notched, or there's probably a term for that, but you know, with my uneducated self, right? I'm surprised I'm not getting like tree seeds from it. Used to get kind of like a tree seed from it, but I don't really see that. Okay, let's pick up some of the goldenrod here. Let's change to a shovel. So we need at least 50 clay, right? So then we'll need a little bit extra clay. So maybe we should collect. Couple hundred here. We'll We'll probably think about disappearing here fairly shortly. Kind of start traveling, going on an adventure. Maybe we'll run up to the top of this mountain here that we're at, and then see what the land has to offer all around us. So yeah, maybe we'll kind of look for that stag that we saw. Maybe we'll collect some hides. We do need a bone shiv, so that is what we'll have to kill something that will, you know, yield us that. So maybe a pig or something, or even a zombie would yield us that. But because we're kind of starting here, we're staying near our starting zone, there won't be very many zombies at all, which is a good thing. And as soon as you wander away from your area, you're going to start getting zombies, right? So maybe I'm going to head down towards the Arctic biome down there, and maybe we'll find some stuff down there. So 56 stones, 203. Let's just kind of pound on this a little bit more. Okay, perfecto. Here we go. I say okay a lot, I notice. When I do my editing, I notice that that's a common kind of word I use, I say. But I don't know. Hopefully that doesn't bother you folk. If it does, I apologize, but it's just the way I am. So, oh, look at that. Can we find weapons? Money. Oh, man. So money's good for paper, and I think we can use money to sell to the trader. So you can use it for one of two things. I usually hold on to the money in case that we collect enough. So what am I doing? I'm kind of coming down this way. There's these big trees here that I want. So we're going to make our way towards these trees here. There's a lot of alpine stuff here. That's pretty cool. I want to harvest one of these big trees here. I also find that the game's performance is awesome. Oh, there's a lot of wood here. Oh, man. It's going to take me a while. So I'll try and talk about stuff. So, yeah. So, basically, I find the game's performance a lot better with Alpha 15. There seems to be some optimizations. I've increased. If you look into... if I hit Escape. If you look into our video options. One thing with the game is there's a bug. When you look into here and hit Apply, it does some funky stuff with the textures. But I increased my view distance to 10. I used to play on 8. I have the field of view to 80. I have the level of detail distance to 70%. I don't play with shadows because it kind of wreaks havoc on my system. I can do tree quality middle, grass distance normal, motion blur off. I have this for my opacity. The water quality low. Particle limiter, I'm not sure what this is about. How accurate particles match falls. Yeah, so I've never really... you know, I looked into this. I have gamma at 150, so I can see everything at night. Reflection quality, texture quality, I actually have on half size instead of quarter size. And yeah, and I play the game at 1280 by 720, so I can record and hopefully give you all a decent product, you know, a decent video to watch. Not sure how many eyeballs are going to watch this one. There's a zombie to the left, as you can see there. Zombies are worth parts, or... you know, experience now, that's another new change, which is kind of exciting. So, oh, look at that. There's a camp there that we could potentially loot. I'm going to leave the camp alone, though. And I'm just going to see if we can find the road for that camp and follow the road. So, I think I want to follow the road to the north, though. So, I just want to chop this tree down. Okay, look at this. Awesome, awesome. I'm going to have to edit that out. If I did, you wouldn't have heard it. So do we have a tree? We do. Blue spruce trees. Excellent. That's what I wanted. The big trees. Okay, so we're going to run along this way. Going to run along the border of both. We need to keep a lookout for nests. We need to keep a lookout for tree stumps. And I think there's a nest right here. It's kind of like that brownish color, right? So that's kind of what I'm noticing. And I might miss stuff because... you know, when you're YouTubing, you're going to kind of have tunnel vision. And, I don't know, a lot of times I find it difficult. When I watch other people, you definitely watch other people kind of miss things, right? It's just whether or not that, you know, someone points that out to you. So let's see here. So I'm just going to kind of head in this direction. I thought that we saw that road in the distance. So, oh yeah, we need some more stamina. Oh, hello, zombie. Hello. Hello. I'm going to have to take you out. Ooh, nice. Look at that. That was worth it. Hey, Chicky. Do we take you out too? Oh, wow. I got an achievement called the Embalmer. Not sure what that means. That is pretty freaking cool. So, oh, look at that. There's a house right there. Maybe we'll kind of hunker down in there? Maybe? Kind of start our base of, well, not base of operations, but yeah, let's go check it out. Let's go check it out. Since we're here, it's 12 o'clock. It's midday. Oh, there's another structure. So this must be point of interest. Yeah, they must have zombies as well. I'm probably missing these things. Because we're watching the buildings and watching the buildings instead of watching the ground. Look at that, there's a floating leaf, is that? Oh, that's probably the trees. Okay. Oh, hello, zombie. We are overheating, so we're going to need to make a plant fiber hat. That's the one thing I've noticed with the update. Oh, hello. Hello. Is that? Oh, we should make. We should also make. Where did it go? Yeah, let's clear the. Oh. Wow. Why am I killing stuff one shot? What's going on? Is it because of Nomad? Oh man, I'm gonna have. Oh man, we need bone. Yeah, I'm just doing a quick check. This will give us a bone shiv, which then we will be able to use to harvest the second one. Oh, this is so awesome. This will give us the bone, I think. Yeah, okay. Perfect. I'm so filled up. Bone shiv. Craft. Whoa! Ah! Go away! Whoa! That's cool. I like the new, when you're stunned, effect. It's like you're underwater or something. Let's see if we can melee this guy. Oh. Come on. What are you doing? What's going on? Why is he like that? Is he stunned? Ah, brutal. I missed. Hello, zombies. Look at that. There's a bunch of you folks. One in the face. Oh, did I hit you or did I miss? Nice. Oh, man. Brutal. We're already dealing with trouble. Oh, no. That was brutal. They timed that one correctly. Ooh. Where's these guys coming from? It's like a horde. Wow. Oh, shoot. Is that a bear? That totally is a bear. Screw that, zombie. So we need to build some arrows here. Oh, man. Hey, let's make these bastards spawn. Hi, folks. Let's go back to the second house here. Oh, man. So we are poisoned now. Look at this. There's like animals galore here. Bird's nest galore. Okay, so we're going to hold out here, I think. I think this is where we're going to build our stand. I think we'll use this area. We'll take over this structure. And I think that is what we shall do. Is this unlocked? No, it's not. Let's see. We're sensed. Maybe we can get away with... Maybe we can lose the zombies. Cool. This is exciting, folks. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. So once we get in here, I think we'll call it an episode. Oh, really? Just two layers of this? Now we're spotted. Oh, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Hey. Come on. There we go. You're toast. Oh no, man. Come on. This is so brutal. Oh, crap, it's so close. Nice. It's toast. Okay, that's not too shabby. At least we can hear the zombies now, so that's kind of cool. Let's get this chicky. Oh, really? Come on. Like, this should be toast. Come on. Really? I hit him in the shoulder. Oh, I missed. Ooh. Okay, let's do this one. He probably ducked it. Oh, nice. Come on. Come on. Oh, man. Whew. That was a lot of work. But it was worth it. We kind of got a level or two, maybe, from all this stuff. Got some loot, some food and stuff. Okay. There's a zombie there. Get out of here. Oh, what's this? We'll have to keep that there. Yeah, we're definitely going to make this our place. Definitely going to make this our place. Let's scrap this. Scrap this. Make sure we have that. Okay, make wooden club. Alright, let's throw that down here. Let's wear this thing. Let's kind of pound this down a bit. Come on, come on. Woo! Where are you guys coming from? Really? We put them on medium spawns, if you noticed. Okay. Whew. Okay. I'm out of arrows. So we need to make arrows. So do this, do this. Okay. We can definitely equip our wooden club. Whew. Yeah, we'll definitely have to put spikes in place here. Let's see here. She's toast. Is he toast? What the frick? There we go. Whew. Running out of stamina, so let's recover some here. Go away. Go away. There's a little crawler guy. Yeah, I don't know what's going on with the zombies' AI. They're pretty, I like to say, dumb. Ooh. I might use the bow here. Okay. Nice, okay. Oh man, so is there loot in these? Yes, there is. We're running out of space. We need to definitely do some inventory management here. We also have water nearby, I think. When we were on that hill, we saw water to the north, I think. So, like in that direction, northwest. So I think we'll be okay. I want to get inside this place. Okay, now we're unmolested. Oh man. Oh, okay, here we go. Home sweet home. So this is it. This will be our home, I think. Pretty small. There's nothing special in it. So let's make some wood frames here. Let's see here. Let's make 10 of these bad boys. Let's make a secure storage chest, because we definitely want to protect our investment here. Yeah, I'm going to put them in the walls here. So where we see this stuff here, I'm going to put the wood frames on two. Let's put one back here. And we're going to kind of solidify the house a tad. It's not going to be the 7-day horde house, I don't think. So we need to do this. Two, three. Okay, so that's good. That's a good start. Now let's make a secure wood door. Right? A chest. Let's put the chest up here so it doesn't get affected. And we're just going to dump everything in here. Except for the glass jar we'll keep. Let's see here. We'll throw the torch. We'll put the torch up. We should plant the trees here. Let's see here. We do have a lot of trees. So let's see here. Let's do that. Put the meat away so that way zombie don't come after us. We can scrap that. Let's keep the painkillers. Let's keep the arrows with us. Sham. Okay. Bone shiv we'll keep. This stuff we'll keep because that's all useful. Trees. We'll plant the trees. Let's plant them a little bit away. Let's plant one here and one here. Okay. And looks like we have another bag here. Excellent. Ooh, nice. A lot of goodies. I'm going to delete the loot containers near us. This is a big tree we'll have to definitely take out, of course. Alright, that's definitely something. We should make a bedroll as it suggests, because we need to place our spawn point. That's your spawn point. And yeah, so looks like Alpha 15 is going to be an awesome adventure. So hopefully all of you will want to kind of tag along for the ride. I'm not promising anything special, nothing really exciting, just watching me survive and seeing how far I get. That's kind of, I heard something, mainly just, all of that. That's what the purpose will be. So you're in a decent biome, I think. Let's put this door up. Okay, let's upgrade the door. Like so. Bang, okay. Now we're getting cozy, so let's see. I don't think there's any lights in here normally, so we'll put it right there. We shall destroy this. This will give us coal, wood, that kind of fun stuff. We will place our bedroll right in the middle of the room here. Why not? That's as good a spot as ever, right? Bam. Let's pick this stuff up. Let's do some looting inside the house here. Well, maybe we can do this at night. The daytime we need to spend outside, so let's deposit our stuff in here. Again, alright, flashlight, ooh, black leather duster, that's exciting. Got some gun parts, got another wooden club, scrap that for wood. The wood chairs we can scrap for wood, but I usually burn them. So, and then I'm just going to deposit that stuff. Okay, this is good. So let's see, what else can we pick up outside here? We need to make a hole at some point. That's definitely on the agenda. Let's smash out this stuff. Let's make some new tools. Let's make a bow. Okay, and then we should make scrap. Scrap. Stone axe. Right. Should scrap this. And we should make another wooden club. Right. Wooden club. Here we go. Craft. Excellent. So let's throw this stuff down in here. Probably put the stone axe there. And then that there. And where's the shovel? Stone shovel. Once we get that forge up and running, we're not going to have a problem with anything. So let's see. What do we need to do with this house? We need to take out this section here. That's definitely a no-no. And then we need to take out about three blocks out. We need to three, four blocks out. We need to take out the grass because we're going to put a bunch of spikes all around the house. And I think I might Yeah, this already has a lip on it, so that's already a built-in defense mechanism for spider zombies, so maybe we'll make a way up to the roof and then make kind of like a platform on the roof. Maybe we could turn this into a base to hold out from the hordes. I don't know. It seems okay. We got a clay deposit right here. I'm going to build a mine going downwards, I think, as well. Yeah, maybe we'll stay here. What do you all think? You know, if there's any eyeballs watching this, then you definitely comment. You let me know what you'd like me to do, if you'd want me to, you know, continue with this base or go searching for a larger town. I think right now, as it stands, it'd be nice to have kind of like a base to have just in case if we don't find a town. So I imagine if we follow the roads, eventually it will lead to a town. So that's not a problem. And maybe once I have more of the map uncovered, maybe I'll do a little bit of cheating and I'll see where kind of the cities are in relation compared to where we are right now. What's that? What's that? There's something moving in the distance. Like a stag? There's another house here as well. I thought I saw it. Maybe it's just my imagination. Maybe just my eyeballs. There's also a bag over here. Where are we? So we were over here. Here we go. This is the bag I was talking about. Look at that. There's another flashlight. Awesome. So I know that the loot, they've changed the loot tables a bit. There we go. I see it. Snap. Yeah, I think I hit it again. Should die bleeding. Come on. There we go. Bone shift. Oh, I see. I have to rebind the Q key. That's the old-fashioned drop key. So you're gonna watch me drop stuff. Let's pick this up quickly. And it looks like there's a bird's nest nearby. And we'll run back. I'm not too worried about the infection, because either two things are going to happen. I'm either going to die, which we don't want to really die, or there'll be infection, right? Or we'll advance to the next stage, so we might find some pills, we might find something. I'm going to collect these for bones as well, because we kind of need the bird's nest, and I'm going to run back here. Yeah, I like this spot. It has a lot of resources. It's all nearby. There's another house to loot over there, similar to ours. And it has these random bags in this biome here, which I like. I think we can also run in the one direction to find, back on the hill maybe, to find, yeah, see, so back over here we could go to pick up the yucca and all that fun stuff. So, man, how many hides do we have? 7 here. Let's see, how many do we have up here? Okay, so I got lots of this stuff now. We're just gonna keep everything. So we have, what, 12? Oh man, we need like 8 more. This is awesome. Awesome sauce. That's for clay. You can throw that stuff in there. The water is not too bad of a deal yet. Let's see what we are for this stuff. Yeah, so we need food and water so we can kind of eat the chili. And then we can actually eat, I think, or drink one of these. And I think the yucca stuff, yeah, we want to make some seeds here, so at least one seed out of it. Let's see here what we are now. Oh yeah, we're a little bit okay. Oh snap, what do we see? Did you see that piggy? Hello? Hi. Ah, where are you? Come on. Hi. Sorry, bro. I need your stuff. Woo! Yeah, I'm just gonna run with the pig a bit. Come on, this is retarded. It's almost nighttime. Where did it go? Well, that's worth the zombie, man. Okay. Come on. There we go. Okay, let's get the pig, and then we're gonna go back. I wonder why he attacked it at first. So will this be enough hides? Oh, the telling tale. The telling tale. We need, what, 3 maybe? I think we had 17. Or it was 12. It was one of the two. So let's see here. Okay, we're gonna collect this for the bones, because it's for glue. Oops. Okay. Let's pick this up. Let's run back. Excellent, excellent. So it looks like that was a successful haul. So let's kind of run back this way. Should be no more zombies here. I think we took care of them. Let's kind of steer away from this house. Looks like we got some more. Oh man, looks like we have every crop pretty much except for potatoes. So that is awesome. Huh. Sun's going down. Oh man, folks. So yeah, so there's gonna be nothing interesting. I'm gonna kind of finish off the night. I'm gonna do some stuff in the house, and I will meet you all in the morning. Or unless something interesting happens, but typically not. So thank you everybody for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this episode, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next one. Bye-bye!